Dear students and teachers, I am Srinivasa Prasad, teacher in St. Joseph Indian High School, Bengaluru. I am teacher in social science and English. And this is an effort to teach you all multiple choice chapter wise in our social science. Dear students, the SSLC board has changed the examination pattern. Now we have 40 marks multiple choice questions. These questions are taken from the content of our textbook. You need to study the 31 lessons in detail. Dear students, earlier you used to answer 3 and 4 mark questions. At least you used to get one and a half for the 2 or 3, 4 lines. But now, MCQ, if you know the answer, you can mark it. Otherwise, it goes out of your hand. Therefore, I feel multiple choice is as challenging as 2, 3 mark or 4 mark questions. That's why in this lockdown period, I try to help you to answer different types of multiple choice chapter wise. Today, I am before you with the first lesson, Advent of Europeans to India, history. Dear students, on your screen, you have multiple choice questions. I read out each and every multiple choice and explain wherever it is required. You know very well, the chapters are the chapters which are dropped for the examination. History, the 10th lesson. Geography, the 1st, 8th and the 12th lesson. Economics, the 3rd and the 4th lesson. Business studies, the 3rd and the 4th lesson. So you need not study all these lessons as they are dropped. Now, you need to concentrate on multiple choice, the 2 variety of multiple choice. First of all, let us discuss history, unit number 1, advent of Europeans to India. The first question is there before you. The navigator was successful in reaching the coast of Calicut in 1498 wars. Dear students, in this chapter, I'm going to present nearly 16 to 17 MCQ, which covers almost all the topics. Let us try. So I think you have already answered all this. The navigator was successful in reaching the coast of Calicut in 1498 was none other than Vasco da Gama. So congratulations, dear students. Here you need to observe Kappadu, the coast. In the coast of Calicut, he reached a village called Kappadu. That also you need to observe. And he left Lisbon. Lisbon is the capital of Portugal. So he left Lisbon and reached Kappadu in the coast of Calicut in Kerala. I wish you all the best. Congratulations to all those who answered Vasco da Gama reached successfully Kappadu village on the coast of Calicut in Kerala in the year 1498. Now, second question is before you. Read the question carefully. And also the options, all the options are almost look similar, but they are not. Let us see. The city of Constantinople was called the gateway of Europe because it, option A, helped the traders of Italy to gain monopoly in trade, helped the traders of Arab to gain monopoly in trade, became the center of international exchange of goods, helped the traders of India to gain monopoly in trade. So these are the 4 options. Many of you have already answered, I think. So the correct option is it became the center of international exchange of goods. So this is what, dear students, you will have to have thorough knowledge over the content of the lesson. Still time is there. Examination is in the month of July 3rd week, as announced by the department. So you have still time to refer the textbook, underline those points. And my effort will help you, I hope. Now we are in the third MCQ. The European nation had the trade monopoly over Arabian Sea till 17th century wars. So you know very well, those who have read the textbook can easily answer this. Dear students, till 17th century, Italy had monopoly over Arabian Sea trade route. Now we are in the MCQ number 4. Around 3 villages in Bengal, the British built. Dear students, you need to be very, very attentive and textbook. You have to have the knowledge of textbook. The first factory, the Fort William, the Presidency, the first trading center. Dear students, it is the first factory they built in Surat. So this is not correct answer. And then the Presidency, it was not only in Bengal. I mean, they made entire Bengal as the Presidency, not in just 3 villages. So that is C also not the correct answer. The first trading center of British was Surat. So the correct option here is the Fort William. So congratulations to all of you who correctly answered. Now we shall go to MCQ number 5. The capture of Constantinople resulted in the dash. The capture of Constantinople resulted in the option A, monopoly on trade by Portuguese, beginning of discovery of sea routes, trade monopoly by Italians, control of trade by Turks. I know very well, many of you have answered by this time. The correct option here is beginning of discovery of sea route. As soon as the Constantinople was captured by Ottoman Turks, the trade route between the East and the West was closed and it led to the discovery of sea route to India. Now, let us move on to the 6th MCQ. A significant role played in implementing Blue Water Policy was. A significant role played in implementing the Blue Water Policy was none other than, yes, you know very well, Francisco de Almeida. Francisco de Almeida played a very significant role in implementing Blue Water Policy. And also let us see what was that. You may have a multiple choice question on Blue Water Policy as well. See, here is a question number 7, MCQ number 7. The purpose of Blue Water Policy was to, number 1, have supremacy over land route, gain control over colonies in India, have supremacy over sea route, increase the number of colonies. Which is the correct answer? The correct answer, you know very well, it is nothing but have supremacy over sea route. Now we have MCQ number 8. The MCQ number 8 is the Black Room tragedy led to the Battle of Buxar, the Anglo-Mysore War, the Battle of Vandivash, the Battle of Plassey. You know very well, the Battle of Plassey is the correct answer. The Black Room tragedy where nearly 123 British people were killed in a small room where there was no proper ventilation, right? As a result of Black Room tragedy, we witnessed the Battle of Plassey, where Siraj Daula was arrested and killed. Now we have MCQ number 9. The European traders arrived in India first and left India at the last. They arrived first and left India at the last. They were none other than Portuguese. MCQ number 10. The Mughal emperor at the time of Battle of Buxar was none other than Shah Alam II. Dear students, congratulations to all of you. You are quickly answering, I hope. Let us continue. MCQ number 11. Chand Sahib was a contender for the Nawabship of which place you need to identify? Chanda Sahib was the contender of Hyderabad or Tanjavur, Carnatic, Madras. So shall I give you a clue? The clue is Arcot was its capital. So correct, it's Carnatic. Carnatic is the correct answer. Chanda Sahib was a contender for the post of Nawabship here. MCQ number 12. In 1617 Common Era, the ambassador who arrived at the court of Jahangir was none other than, dear students, you have 4 options, Sir Deakin, Sir Thomas Rowe, Sir Campbell, Sir Thomas Munro. You are very correct. In the year 1617, Sir Thomas Roe visited the court of Mughal Emperor Jahangir. Congratulations to all of you. Dear students, here you may have a questions. You may have a question, who sent him, from which court he came to the court of Mughal Empire. So you need to write James II. From James II, from the court of James II, he visited the court of Mughal Emperor Jahangir. MCQ 13. The first Carnatic War ended with a treaty called, you know very well, it was nothing but the Treaty of Aix-la-Chapelle. Congratulations to all of you. MCQ number 14. The Dutch limited themselves to spice-rich islands because they were unable to face competition here. They lacked finance and human resource. They were unable to face competition from Portuguese. They were invited by people of Southeast Asia. The correct answer is, yes, you are correct. They were unable to face competition here, particularly from English and French. Now we are in the MCQ number 15. English saw laurels and French witnessed political setback in the battle or in the war. That is, First Carnatic War, Second Carnatic War, Third Carnatic War, or the Battle of Plassey. Dear students, you are very much correct. It is the Third Carnatic War. English saw laurels and French witnessed a major political setback. We have the 16th MCQ. Mir Zafar had to pay rupees 17 crore and 70 lakh to the British, you know, because Siraj Daula attacked on the Fort William and destroyed it and caused severe loss to British. Therefore, the successor of Siraj Daula, Mir Zafar, had to pay 17 crore and 70 lakh. Dear students, now we are in the last question, MCQ number 17 of the first lesson, Advent of Europeans to India. Madras was handed over to British for the purpose of trade by, you know very well, you have read the textbook. Those who have read the textbook can only answer, dear students, because all the questions will be direct and simple. But even to answer simple and direct question, you need to have thorough command over the content of the textbook. So the correct answer is the King of Chandragiri. Dear students, I wish you all the best. This is a small effort from my side to help you out. I meet you in the next class for the second lesson in history. Thank you.